It does, mate. Sorry.
Okay, well, depends. But if you get a Z in the text, it means the zoo.
Where?
There's a place in front of the entrance.
The zoo?
Yeah.
Ollie, babe. And faith, and that is the only way we will save
for the chicken breast that we were looking at a quarter cup of honey, and remember to use local honey.
I must have been sleepwalking.
Oh, that is very dangerous. I once took too many Ambien, and I bought a racehorse online. Oh. Okay, you need to go back downstairs, Abby.
Okay.
Carefully.
Yeah.
Are you all right to do that?
Yeah. Oh, gosh, my phone, too. I was in such a...
I'll get all this.
Please.
Go on.
I was...
You want me to come with
no,
you?
No, thank you. I'm sorry about this. Oh, my God. How did you get down here?
When I saw that mess upstairs, I knew my mom would be busy for the next 2 hours.
What do you want to do for 2 hours?
I don't know.
I didn't want to sleepwalk again.
Well, sorry to barge in. The twins usually...
Doc says you're gonna live.
Give it to me. You're poor enough to stop this. What right do you sit this room? What need to you to be the rest? You're rich enough.
Bad luck strikes midnight. Tonight.
Money!
Hi.
Good morning.
I've just been like running up and downstairs, like moving things around and packing boxes, like trying not to think about you calling me with Grammy nominations.
I know. Well, I'm trying to get the full list, because right now, in the big categories of album, record, song, you are not nominated.
Oh, okay. This is good. This is fine.
Yeah. And it's very similar. Everything is like this. You know, it's so weird. I said, it's,
this is, you know what? Like, this is fine. This is, yeah. I just need to make a better record.
Well, Reputation is a great record.
No, I'm making a better record.
Well, and I'm still waiting for the pop, you know, the pop categories. Those should be hitting any second. So do you want me to call you right back when those hit?
Sure.
Okay, I'll call you right back.
Okay, thanks.
Bye.
Bye.
The other.
I'm like halfway to sad guy. What?
You know.
No, no.
Pull a Han Solo.
Drat.
What's going on?
Nothing, I promise.
I guess if we do this over the phone, you can't actually hit me. Yeah, cute. You wanna play Best Life?
Sure.
Okay, Best Life. You're stuck in Illinois forever. Go.
You entitled intellectual snob.
You pathetic.
Birthday to you and me and Desmond Winken Bay.
This is the nicest birthday in a while.
Yeah, not for Judy.
Who's Judy?
It doesn't matter.
It's not a big deal. She just.
Still thinking about Matt Murdock?
He loved this city.
Escape is impaired.
Okay, if you'd like to join me, take your shoes off. Let's stretch out all those tiny little muscles, bones in the feet. Just do this here. Stretch them all out and then flex your feet and then very slowly bend from the waist. This is a stretch for the hamstring region. Just bend as far as you can, as far as you comfortably can. Okay, and then just let your head fall naturally. Feel us in through the lower back too. Those bottom exercises that we did, if you can do that standing one, try to get 20 in or 30 in a day. I try to get 100 in every couple of days. Not often that I can do that, but when I try, I just notice a big difference in the rear area. Yeah, who invented those three-way mirrors anyhow? I don't know. Anyhow, okay, enjoy your stretch. Okay, come up out of that stretch, and let's do a stretch for the inner thigh region here, just sitting like so, feet are together, grab your ankles. Sit up nice and tall. And listen, if at some point in time during the cool down I haven't taken off my runners and you like to take off your runners, you can do it. That's fine. Okay, if you've been with me for a while, you know all of my tricks and my routines, and it's okay to take off your runners after the cardiovascular segment. For the SOS segment, you can do that. Okay, there we go, sitting up nice and tall. Feel a stretching through the adductor here. Slow your breathing down. Okay. Back to center, and let's do our pretzel sit in this position here. If you can't do this, just leave your leg here, that's fine. Okay, or here in this position, sit up nice and tall, use this elbow against the knee and twist right around for maximum stretch. Come back to center, same thing over to the other side. Okay, there you go. Sitting up tall as you can. Posture is really important. Okay, there you go. You did a great job today, you really did. office right around the stretch. And for those of you who are working during the commercial breaks, plural, that's good, that's great. Some of you are even doing some cycling after the show, that's wonderful. Okay, come back to center. And I'm gonna stretch my back. But thank you so much for joining me. My name is Cynthia Kerluck. Until next time, please take care of yourself.
Okay, it's a fact of life we need exercise to feel good and stay in shape. But no, you don't have to go to a gym at an ungodly hour of the morning and sweat with a bunch of strangers. Just stay tuned for fitness expert Denise Austin's Daily Workout, next, only on Lifetime.
She's having trouble with Rick again. I'll go downstairs, Becky. I'll call you back. Oh. I'm sorry, Walter. Are you bleeding?
The truth. Are you spying on your father?
Who's he kissing right this minute?
Listen to this.
I have to make them stop.
Do you think
how am I gonna explain this to Walter?
She came over and cooked it. She brought two bags of groceries like she was staying here for a year.
Jonah, it's good that your father's dating. It's just hard on you. It's something that you think you want, but then when it actually happens, it scares you.
Couldn't do it. How did I get here?
You told a lie and got on a plane.
That's not what I mean. I'm going back over there tomorrow and talk to him. I am.
Okay. Good. Goodbye.
Beck.
What?
Is this crazy?
No. That's the weirdest part about it.
Thank you. I love you.
I love you too.
Good night.
Yes?
Hi, I'm Dr. Hauser.
Oh, right, the genius.
Well, I'm not really a genius. I am a genius. But believe me, I know a lot of stuff. Tons. So don't think I'm not a genius.
You gonna check me out or what?
Oh, of course. Uh-huh. Just checks out good to me. Real good. You see, the reason they sent me in here is that my specialty is the heart. And it's very important that before a surgery of this type, that your heart be functioning in a very special functioning way. All systems tip-top, you know.
Oh, sure. Listen. Isn't my heart on the other side?
Oh, well, it's important to sneak up on it.
So how am I doing?
Oh, boy. There's a heart in there, all right. A big one. Listen, despite my being a doctor, I hang around with a lot of juveniles. And one such juvenile I know is a very big fan of yours. If it wouldn't be too much to ask, could you give him an autograph?
Sure, no problem.
His name is Vinny Del Pino.
Doctor, is this necessary?
Well, sometimes when the heart moves, you can get a different perspective. Medically speaking, of course. It's a very new concept.
Wee bit past your bedtime, isn't it, darling?
Oh, has anyone seen my skates? I can't seem to find my new pair.
The girl thinks she's on holiday.
Oh, no. It's bad for your wind. I'm still in training. God knows why. I get up every morning at dawn to practice.
Dawn?
I bet you're fun on dates.
Makes me feel good. Guess you gotta want it more than being loved. Isn't that how you feel about acting?
It depends on the love.
I suppose. Well, I'll see you in the morning.
You don't like her?
What's she doing here? She's just a baby.
You nervous too?
Me? I'm scared to death.
But you've been doing this for years. But I can remember seeing you in...
I started early. It never gets easier.
Well, there's always the casting jacuzzi.
What?
Oh, I'd like to get my hands on the guy who invented the snooze alarm.
Morning.
Oh, man, let me help you with those suckers. Come on now, huh? That's all right. That's not hard, buddy.
Thanks, Mort, but I was trying to put the boot on.
Oh, I guess we start off the day on the wrong foot, huh?
Well, man, I'm really famished. I feel like Gandhi to McDonald's. Come on now.
Abby! Game starts in 4 minutes. Why ain't you warm?
I am warm.
Jesus, Epi, this is your professional debut tonight. Me and guys give their left nut to be in your shoes. And you're leaving your fastball in the locker room for some piece of ass.
Skip! It is me. I am not some, quote, piece of ass, unquote.
Well, you know what? You are one to talk. You go through, like, 6 housekeepers a year. I'm not snapping at you. I am... angry. Yes, at them. Yes, at them, the police, at Rick, at Maria, at the dry cleaners who destroyed another blouse today, at the gardener who keeps overwatering the lawn. I just thought that I would wake up today and I would feel better, you know? But I was still mad. And I realized that it had nothing to do with my car being stolen. I wake up like this every morning. I am angry all the time, and I don't know why, Carol. I don't know why, and I... Yeah, yeah, call me.
Where do you think it should go?
exactly what I was thinking. To save me from ruin.
They're coming out.
Attention, Roger's coming out of Link.
Oh, God. Oh. Where's the lab coat? Where's the lab coat?
Who's got my goddamn cigarette? Guys.
A conservative friend called me up and said, I just can't do it. I don't know if I'm voting for Obama, but I can't have her. She shouldn't be in Washington, let alone inside the White House.
It's the mattress savings event at Lowe's Home Improvement. Now until April 16th, save big on America's number one mattress brand. The 10-inch Serta Hybrid mattress is the perfect blend of gel memory foam and Serta coils to provide full body support for revitalizing sleep. Built here in the USA and backed by the Serta Mattress 10-year warranty. Order online at Lowe's.com and get Serta Comfort delivered directly to your door.
Man, what's the Wi-Fi password?
Nonus retorsum danger semper.
Holy shit. Guys, Panther.
What?
Oh my God, you're right.
That's what I'm saying. The Panthers are in Pennsylvania.
Possible. Here we come.
Oh, what are you still doing here? You should be at college.
You're dressed.
Yeah.
Well, that's good. I'm just...
What? Surprised I'm not in my pyjamas?
Yeah. You look lovely, Mum.
Oh, stop it.
No, I'm serious. I mean it.
Well, I thought if I go out without any makeup on, I'll scare people, won't I?
You're going out?
Yeah. Yeah, I thought I'd have a walk around the red road, you know, get a bit of fresh air. What? That's all right, isn't it? I thought you'd be pleased.
Oh, yeah, I am, of course. Let's go out together.
I've not got my shoes on and that.
I'll wait.
No, it's fine. You go. You'll be late. Have a good afternoon.
All right. Love you, Mum.
Yeah, love you too.
See ya.
Bye. I thought you'd be back before now.
Yeah, well, how was your walk on the red wreck?
Oh, well, it looked like it was going to chuck it down. I'll go tomorrow.
Right.
Don't give me now time about it, Si.
I'm not.
I will go tomorrow.
Yeah. I've got a bit of good news.
Oh, yeah?
Got myself a job. Only delivering for the chippy, but you know.
Well, from Tiny Acorns.
Yeah, exactly. We'll be okay. Got this job, have a bit of money coming in. Hey, might even get the odd free chippy tea.
I'm sorry. I was coming off it at the end of the month anyway. It was just one more time, just to clear the credit card and build up a bit of a buffer.
For me? For when I give birth?
Well, no, not just for you.
You'd never have started if it weren't for me.
We didn't hold a gun to me, Ed.
No, but it didn't help though, did it? Your 12-year-old daughter suddenly finding out she was pregnant.
Well, you leaving school, that ain't going to help either. Look, I know it's difficult, but these kids, they'd have moved on to something else next week.
They might. We won't.
What's that mean?
How else are you going to make sure that Arthur has them new shoes he needs? Or that my baby has them bits and pieces, or that Hope has something hot in her belly before she goes to school? Me leaving school will help. I can start earning.
Babe, no one's going to employ a pregnant 12-year-old.
I told you, this is my fault. I'm going to help.
It's good to hear from you, Freddie.
Oh.
You're not.
Freddie's gone on a bender.
Of course he has.
Yeah, so he hasn't got time to take pictures of his feet.
Mm-hmm. So here we are.
Well, it's just a one-off. Just until we pay Shiv back. Don't tell me, Mother.
Why don't you take some black and white ones while you're at it? We could try them at the Tate.
Go and talk to him.
Hmm? Look, I want to see the end of this first.
Go.
All right.
any news on Denzel? You know, the boy that came in just before me? Yeah?
Doctor said it was okay, showed nothing, but...
Anna, can you believe it? You get invited to a war ceremony and then there's no bubbly.
And we'll get you in.
Sleep with him. But you thought about it though, innit? Oh, this just gets better and better, innit?
We're investigating him and he...
Letting it happen? I've seen that girl, you know. And she's really into him. And she thinks that he's...
I need to find Howie. What, you gonna tell him? Or the police? Or Jack? It's fine, I wouldn't blame you. I'm just gonna tell him everything. I'll come clean.
I need to find out that Denzel is okay.
Oh, I'm sorry I'm late. I know you're meeting your mum soon.
Oh, it's fine. She cancelled anyway. She's devastated about all that photo stuff.
Oh, I can't believe those kids did that. Anyway, it's not fair me taking liberties just because we're engaged now. You're still my responsibility when I'm on the clock, aren't you?
So where have you been?
Well, I just went to Charity and Mackenzie's wedding setup. Thought I might get a few ideas.
Really?
Hmm. Oh, I got some wedding magazines too. That one, it's got a really good checklist. I've turned the corner over for you. Thought it might be a good place to start.
Oh, that's so thoughtful of you.
I had to come back with something, otherwise it would have been a wasted trip. They don't seem ready at all. No one knows if the wedding's even going to go ahead. They got arrested or something.
What?
Can you imagine? Missing your big day after all of that work and all that money.
Yeah, well, it's not really about the money, is it?
I know. I spent all night thinking about what you said yesterday. Why do you think I went and got all of these? You deserve your special day. What do you think about this?
Oh, my God. I can't tell when you're being serious.
Doesn't every girl want a fairy tale wedding?
They look ridiculous.
Probably seemed like a good idea at the time.
When would that ever seem like a good idea?
And now they've got to live with the photos decade after decade after decade.
Excuse me for interrupting.
Themed wedding? What do you think?
She's a fairy. I'm not 100% sure what he thinks he is, but...
Is that the sort of thing you're planning?
No, I'm going to ride in on a big white horse.
Has Jay been texting you?
Oh, no, my phone's on silent.
There's an issue at Hop. I need you to come in.
Now?
Well, it's your business too, Gabby. It should matter to you. Especially as it looks like you'll be the breadwinner.
Do you know what it is?
Sometimes the ultrasound doesn't give us all the information.
Okay.
I'm sure your GP's already explained this, but lumps in the breast can have lots of different causes.
She thinks it's probably just a blocked milk duct.
And that's certainly a possibility. But it does look a little bigger than we'd expect, so I am going to recommend that you have a biopsy just to be sure. It's a really simple procedure. Okay, we just insert a very thin needle into your breast so that we can extract some cells for testing.
Yeah, Manpreet... Dr. Sharma, sorry, she's already explained this. Does it hurt?
No, you'll feel some pressure. Might be a little uncomfortable, but no, it's not usually painful.
So when can you do it? I'll have to come back.
No, I can pop you into reception. I'll go and get the radiologist. The actual biopsy only takes about 15 minutes.
And how quick will you know?
Results normally take about a week.
A week? No, I can't wait that long.
Amelia, the good news is we've seen you really quickly. Okay, you were lucky we had that cancellation.
Yeah, but what about if it ends up being serious? It's just me and my baby.
I know it's hard, but try not to worry. Is there someone you can call?
No.
Right. Yeah, see ya. That was Sid.
Oh?
Yeah, there's a bit of a dawn at Woolley tonight. Celebrate Jack and Diane getting engaged. Well, I said we'd go. Be good, probably. Plenty of booze anyway.
If you've got any spare time, I think we'd do better to stay in and talk, don't you?
Hey, I'm usually the one who wants to talk. You're usually the one who wants to go out and down a few beers.
You'll never let it go, will you?
What?
I've tried and tried, but you'll never let us get past it, will you?
What?
You know damn well what! That I didn't talk to you about the abortion and it's destroying us, Paul. It's destroying our marriage.
All right, so we get to Ireland and then what? Because we can't stay there, can we? They'll be looking for us, Cain.
We lie low for a bit after that. World's our oyster.
OK, like where?
Well, I don't know, do I? I mean, get us across to America or something. I mean, there must be a dingle somewhere with access to a fishing boat.
A fishing boat?
Yeah, we'd be in the clear. I think we should really do this.
Gotta say, it's one option.
Well, I've got to admit, he nearly persuaded me.
All right, so now you're going to go all respectable
again.
No,
listen, I appreciate what you're saying, both of you, but let's be realistic.
Yeah, we are.
No, we are not. Seriously, Debbie, we're not. International jet setting on a dingle boat is not realistic, it's insane. So let's get this one thing straight. Nobody is absconding nowhere, do you understand? Because that's just dingle thinking. And I don't want to be looking over my shoulder for my whole life, thank you. No, I'm sorry, but... Oh, let's just clear up, eh? Hey, you want to join me?
Yeah, why not?
You know, you've got to admire him, Chris.
You are?
Oh, he stitched me up good and proper, hasn't he?
You think I'm going to stop short of saying, nice one, Chris?
I'm not exactly celebrating his achievements myself, am I?
Hey. Come on. You're going to get through this. All said and done, you didn't do it.
That's the first time you've ever admitted it.
Yeah, well, maybe it's because I wish you did. God knows we all wanted him dead.
Except me. And now I'm going to do life for it.
Listen to me. Yeah. You might. But if you do, just remember there's two other Tates out there. And you go down, they're both going to pay.
Lie down here. And then I'll make you lunch. And if you're good, you can have some sweets after.
Close your eyes. I haven't given you this for quite a while.
Oh, cheers, no. If you want sex, I'm too tired.
No, I didn't mean to. Right, you can open them.
Ooh, my favourite. Thanks. You know, this is even better than, you know.
Oh, not sure how to take that.
You know what I mean?
So how was your day in the end?
Well... The big news is that Henry is going to buy the pub after all.
Really? That's brilliant. At least he did the right thing in the end, I suppose.
Hmm.
I mean, you okay now?
Yeah. Good move playing your trump card.
I know you won't be able to resist the scotch egg.
Yeah, but you might need a sweetener when I tell you the rest of my news.
Go on.
I've been offered a job at Newton and Ridley's head office.
Seriously?
As Henry's PA.
Right. Oh. What about your shifts at the Rovers?
Well, this job would be full-time, so I'd have to give them up. What do you think, Chez? You know, I wouldn't even consider it if it wasn't...
No, I know. It's just that... It's Henry.
I want you to be all right with it.
I'm proud of you. I am. Come here.
I know. I heard you coming in.
Sorry.
I was already awake, but Sash might give you an earful because you woke Olivia. Come back to bed.
I can't. I have to get to work.
Need you taking over?
Yeah, I know. I'm just offering to help.
Of course you are.
Hey, play nice.
Did someone use all the hot water?
I put the immersion on. Just only take a...
Are you still at this? They have a whole washout for your kombucha since you started.
I finished ages ago. Want to make a good impression on Zoe.
Oh, she knows your well house, Trent.
No harm in hammering the message home.
One cushion. R.I.P.
I asked her to pick up some oat milk and she looked at me like it was a huge deal.
You're imagining it.
Something going on. We were getting along great and then, I don't know, suddenly she's ice cold at me.
Right.
I'm gonna call her on it, but not until I get a proper tenancy agreement.
Maybe she had a row with Alex.
Why'd you get out of me?
Hey.
Did you pick up the oat milk? Forgot.
I'll pop over the shop.
Just use a bit of cow's milk. Oh, no, sorry. That would be cannibalism.
Is everything okay?
Fine.
Just, you seem a bit off with me.
No, I'm not.
That's everyone just chill out.
Sorry, do you live here?
No, I'm just looking to camp.
Alex, I don't see you paying any rent.
Is everything okay with you and Alex?
What's that supposed to mean?
I'm trying to be your friend. That was my imagination as well.
This is nice, isn't it? Just the two of us. I'm sorry I had to drag you into all my dramas.
Well, your troubles are my troubles.
You really do care, don't you? And you make me laugh. A lot. How'd you fancy going to Thailand? I'd love you to meet Bex. I mean, I don't know when she's going to call again, let alone come home. Well, don't look too excited. If it's the full moon parties you're worried about, we don't have to go.
I can't just take off. I've got commitments.
Like what?
Oh, the end of the tax year's upon us. I'm playing organ on Good Friday.
No, I'm not suggesting we take off first thing. Listen, I know it's early days, but I really feel committed to us.
Me too. You know that.
Then think about it.
I was getting worried.
I wasn't sure when you'd be back, so I went for a long walk.
Oh, me too.
We've definitely done our 10,000 steps today, then. I counted mine in my head, and I'm occupational hazard. Accountant. Sorry.
Well, I found myself going to see Dot at the cemetery. I thought being there might make me feel some of her pearls of wisdom.
Well, did it?
It's not that I've never thought about having another baby. I really wanted to. I just knew I didn't want to do it on my own. You know, I've been single for so long that I just put it at the back of my mind. You and me, out of the blue, weren't we?
Well, I never ever expected to meet anyone.
What, ever?
Well, it won't surprise you to know. I was one of those kids who never fitted in. But Mum were brilliant. She never made me feel different. Well, she loved me so much. It was all I ever needed. And I thought, one day I'm going to love my own child so much that no matter what life throws at them, they won't care. But girlfriends and that... Well, that was for the other boys, not me. And when I met Debbie, she actually liked me. I thought I'd won the lottery. And when she got sick, I thought that was it. I thought I'd had my chance of being with someone. I mean, because you don't win the lottery twice in one lifetime, do you? Well, not the big prize. But I did.
We're so lucky that we found each other. But what if trying for a baby changes everything?
Don't lose hope.
No. Talk to Dolores?
Nope.
But you're still suspended?
Yep.
And you threatened her?
Well, I made it clear I can fight my coroner.
Katie Taylor, eat your heart out.
I am no pushover.
See, this is who I grew up with. Badass Anna.
Ah, come on. What is it with you? The Rice Krispies are all gone. There's not even a carved leg left in the gaff. And look at you. You know Olivia loves a cereal. Why would you eat it?
I'm starving. Sorry. Sorry, Olivia.
Well, have you already had cereal for breakfast?
Yeah, well, she wanted some for lunch too. She's a kid, and it's Sunday, it's allowed.
No worries, I'll go to the shop and get some more.
Well, thank you, Georgie, but you didn't eat the cereals. You scoffed them so you can buy them, that's how it works.
Scoffed is a bit harsh.
I know you're getting dressed today.
It's a day of rest.
Hmm, you've plenty of those.
You're just jealous.
Hmm, maybe I am. Have you heard from Dolores?
Oh, can people stop asking me that?
I'm being nice.
Anna's a little bit stressed, you know, the whole having no job thing.
I am handling it, thank you. Less digs would help.
You know what would help me? You all not eating Olivia's food.
Head Rick. What?
Nothing.
I don't want to hear another word of Dolores, the medical centre, or cereal.
We hear you.
Yeah, we really do.
You're remembering your liquid intake. Good. And how was today?
Fine.
You're doing very well.
All things considered.
Yes. Anyway. Rest here. The nurse will come and tell you when you can go. I'll see you again soon.
Any word on a donor? Sorry, you tell me, unless you're being particularly cruel.
You'll know as soon as we do.
Yes.
This time.
Of course there is.
That's the spirit.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, Derva. Thanks for coming.
That's no bother. There you go.
Actually, it's not why I asked you to come. It's just if you were with Gar when I phoned, he'd have wondered why I wanted to see you.
Sorry, why did you want to see me?
To talk about Gar. About him being a donor.
Oh, no. Did the test results come back? Is Eileen not a match?
There is no Eileen.
What?
There's no Eileen. I made her up. There's no donor.
You made her up?
In my defense, it was spur of the moment.
Stop.